Hi friends, in this video we are studying theory of machine chapter, gear trains, objective questions and answers. So first I want to give some introduction about gears, in which first one is spur gear. A spur gear where it has a straight teeth and parallel to the axis of the wheel, where one gear rotates in certain direction, either it is a clockwise or anticlockwise, and the other gear will rotate opposite to that of the driver gear. Helical gear. In helical gear what happens? Their teeth incline to the axis of the shaft. So in the form of helix, and the name is helical gear. So here you can see the teeth are inclined. So this is the helical gear. There are two types of configuration in the helical gear. One is parallel configuration, where axis of the shafts are parallel. Another one is closed configuration, where axis of the shafts are in different. Rack and pinion. Here this portion is called pinion and this portion is called rack, and here torque can be converted into linear force by meshing a rack with a pinion. Here what they are telling is torque can be converted into a linear force. There is a some rotating torque is there. So that torque is converted into a linear force by meshing a rack and pinion. So rack can, here rack moves in a straight line where pinion turns. That we can see in the animation. Bevel gear. In bevel gear there is a intersecting but coplanar shafts connected by gears are called bevel gears. Straight bevel gears can be used on shaft at any angle, but right angle is the most commonly used. And non-intersecting, non-parallel type, there is a worm gear. In your worm gears, this is used to transmit power at an angle of 90 degree, that you can see here in the animation, whereas high reduction is required. Sun and planet gear. Here the middle gear is called as sun, whereas the gear which rotating around the sun gear is called planet gear. And then apicyclic gear, this is somewhat similar to sun and planet gear. Here also there is one gear which is in the middle, and there are arrangement of gears, more than three or only one gear may be there, and this is also part of sun and planet gear. Compound gear. Here you can see there is gear 1, this is normal gear, and gear 2 is a compound gear, where two gears are mounted on a same shaft, and the rotation speed of the gear 2 is equal to rotation speed of the gear 3, that is n of gear 2 is equal to n of gear 3, because both the gear 2 and 3 are mounted on a same shaft. And riveted gear is similar to that of the compound gear, and when there is a high reduction of area is required, we are using the riveted gear. So let's begin with the first question. The gears are used to convert two parallel shafts, except spur gear, helical gear, double helical gear and bevel gear. So they are asking, in out of these gears, which gears is used to connect two parallel shafts? So here we can see a bevel gear, where it is used to connect shafts, those are perpendicular. Therefore option D is connector. Second question, the gear used to convert rotary motion into translating motion is. So here the gear is used to convert rotary motion to translating motion. that we know, that is rack and pinion. Therefore, option C is correct option. Which of the following type of gear has inclined teeth? Spur gear, helical gear, spiral gear, all of above. So here helical gear has a inclined teeth, that you can see here. The teeth are here inclined. The point of contact of two pitch circles of matching gears is called pressure point, pitch point, module, contact point. So they are asking the point of contact of two pitch circles. Here we can see two pitch circles of the gear 1 and gear 2. This point of contact is called as contact point. Therefore, option D is correct option. The circular pitch of a gear is given by pi d upon t, pi d upon 2t, 2 pi d upon t, pi d upon 3t, where d is diameter of pitch circle, t is number of teeth. Therefore, pi d upon t is the correct option. The circular pitch of a gear is given by pi d upon t. This is the circular pitch. This distance from here to here, this distance is called as circular pitch. The module of a gear is given by d upon t, 2d upon t, t upon 2t, d upon 3t. So d is the diameter of pitch circle and t is the number of teeth. So the module of the gear is d upon t, diameter of pitch circle upon number of teeth. Which of the following does not give velocity ratio of gears? Omega 2 upon omega 1, it is a velocity ratio. Speed of gear 1 upon speed of gear 2, this is not a velocity ratio. This is the correct answer. Therefore, option B is correct option. Which of the following pressure angle in degrees is commonly used for gears? 15 degree, 20 degree, 25 degree and 30 degree. So commonly used pressure angle is 20 degree. So angle made in the gear. This angle is called pressure angle, and pressure angle commonly used for gears is 20 degree. Length of arc of contact is given by length of path of contact upon cos pi, length of path of contact upon sin pi, length of path of contact into cos pi and length of path of contact into sin pi. So here we can see arc of contact, the portion of a circular surface that is in contact with another surface. So here arc of contact is EFG or GPH, that you can see. This is E, F, EPF, sorry, E, P and F. This length is called arc of contact. So arc of contact is equal to length of path of contact upon cos pi. Therefore, option A is correct option. So here we have a two gears, and here first gear is driver, second gear is driven, and speed ratio we can write here N1 upon N2 is equal to T2 upon T1. And one more thing we can observe here, when the driver is rotating in clockwise direction, driven shaft is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So we may can use minus T2 upon T1 only for the understanding of rotation direction. If it is anti-clockwise, we write it as minus. So if there are three gears, driver rotates in clockwise, middle gear rotates in anti-clockwise, and the end gear rotates in clockwise direction. So if there are odd number of gears, the direction of rotation is same. Here in the last figure we can see there are even number of gears. So driver rotates in clockwise, second gear rotates anti-clockwise, third gear rotates clockwise, and the driven or follower rotates in anti-clockwise direction. That means when there are even number of gears, the direction of rotation is opposite as that of the driver gear. That is, you are seeing driver is rotating in clockwise, driven or follower is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, and the speed ratio for these gears we can write as speed of driver in RPM to the speed of driven in RPM equal to number of teeth on driven gear to the number of teeth on driver gear. That N1 by N2 equal to N2 by N3 is equal to number of teeth on driven, T2 upon T1 and T3 upon T2, because T2 is the driven for the gear 1, because gear 1 is driver gear, so it is T2 upon T1. When we come to fourth gear, it is T3 upon T2, because here T2 is the driver and T3 is the driven, therefore it is T3 upon T2 for the this figure. Figure B we can write like this. And one more thing, train value is 1 upon speed ratio. That is nothing but we are writing this in reverse. In a gear train of odd number of idler gears, the direction of motion of the driven gear is same that of driving gear, opposite as that of the driving gear, depend on number of teeth, none of above. So they are telling that there are odd number of idle gears. The idle gear here, gear number 2, this is odd number because it is only one gear. So the direction of rotation is, here we can see direction of rotation, it is same. Therefore option A is same as that of driving gear is correct option. In a simple gear train consists of 3 gears wheels with 30, 20 and 12 teeth respectively, the velocity ratio of third wheel to first wheel would be. So they are telling that there are 3 gears and the teeth are 30, 20 and 12 teeth. So they are asking velocity ratio of third wheel to first wheel. That is, velocity ratio of third wheel N3 upon N1. We have normal practice of making a velocity ratio of N1 by N3. But here they are making a twist, like telling velocity ratio of third wheel to the first wheel. Therefore N3 upon N1. So we can find the velocity ratio by putting the teeth values, that is equal to 2.5. Therefore option B is correct option. A gear train in which at least one of the gear axis is in motion relative to the frame is known as compound gear, epicyclic gear, bevel gear or spur gear. So in epicyclic gear train, what happens? At least one of the gear axis is in motion in relative to the frame. So here we can see one of the gear, at least one. So there is no chance, if we have no, if we don't have these gears, then at least one gear is in motion relative to the frame. Therefore the answer is epicyclic gear. What is the speed and direction of output shaft in a given compound gate drain. So they are asking the speed of the output shaft, because this is the input shaft. So they are asking what is the speed of the output shaft. So let me call this as gear number 4, because this is gear number 3, 2 and 1. So they are asking what is the speed of the gear number 4. So we have N4 upon N1 equal to T1 upon T2 upon T3 upon T4. So once we put the value, N4 is equal to 240 rpm in clockwise direction. Drain value of a gate drain is equal to speed ratio reciprocal of speed ratio double the speed ratio half the speed ratio. We know that drain value equal to 1 upon speed ratio. So here we can answer it as answer B, reciprocal of speed ratio. An epicyclic gate drain shows in figure. The outer ring gear is fixed while the sun gear rotates counterclockwise at 100 rpm. Let the number of teeth on the sun, planet and outer gears be 50, 25 and 100 respectively. The ratio of magnitude of angular velocity of the planet gate to the angular velocity of the carrier arm is. So they are asking the ratio of magnitude of angular velocity of the planet gate to the angular velocity of the carrier arm, where they are given speed of sun gear is 100 rpm. So here we have, this is the sun gear and its speed is 100 rpm. Number of teeth on the sun gear, that is TS, is equal to 50. So this sun gear has 50 teeth. Teeth on the planet gear, that is TP, is 25. So this planet gear has teeth of 25 and teeth on outer ring gear is 100. So here we have outer ring gear. So these teeth are 100. So after forming this table, we have speed of sun gear, ns is equal to x plus y, and speed of outer ring gear r, nr is equal to y minus x into ts by tr. Therefore we have speed of sun gear as equal to 100, therefore x plus y is equal to 100, and outer ring gear is fixed, it is not rotating, therefore this will become 0. And also let me put the values of TS and TR. We have TS value as 50 and TR value is 100 is equal to 0. So this will become y minus 0.5x is equal to 0. That means y equal to 0.5x. Let me put this in this equation. Therefore we have ns value, we have y value, we will get the x value, and the x value is 66.66 rpm, and the y value is 33.34 minus 66.66 into 0.5 50 by 25, that is equal to minus 99.99 RPM. Therefore, the ratio is x upon y minus 99.99 divided by 33.32. We get it as 3. So this is the answer for this question. 3.
If you have any questions or comments, text in the comment box. And don't forget to subscribe, because subscription is free and also you get the notification of upcoming videos. And please like and share. Thank you.